My name is Dominic Sidhu. We're standing in the exhibition Black Swan at Regan Projects. I curated the show. I also worked with Tora Peterson and Therese Duprez on placing works by a lot of these artists within the sets of Black Swan. A lot of the works we chose were sort of black, white, silver, and kind of about this psychological mirroring point between the Black Swan and the White Swan. Black Swan as an exhibition is kind of a continuation of those ideas with similar artists that were involved in the film and then some other artists who were kind of inspired by the film. The exhibition has some of the most relevant conceptual artists sort of at the forefront of contemporary art right now. Douglas Gordon, Matthew Barney, Sergei Jensen, Katarina Fritsch, Dan Graham, Anish Kapoor, Richard Prince. Well, there's an amazing piece by Pierre Huy called The Island, which is a really small scale, very intimate mirror. A small circular shape in the center of the mirror has been sort of violently scratched out, but when it's put up against a surface or a wall, there's kind of this beautiful white circle that emerges. There's that violence of scratching something out that becomes really beautiful on the face or in reflection. For the exhibition, Richard Phillips created a new painting called Into the Darkness that kind of envisions this figure in this kind of sexualized state through a keyhole, which in this case is a swan feather. It's the silhouette of a swan feather. The kind of black of the background bleeds into the image, and they're kind of simultaneously at war with one another, and there's this question, who's overtaking who? Is this kind of seductive darkness overtaking the image, or vice versa, and what's more vulnerable and what's impenetrable? We're standing on a mirrored floor by Walid Beshti that starts out as completely clean laminated mirror. As you walk on the floor, cracks literally emerge under your feet, and throughout the course of the exhibition, the fractures and cracks and scratches sort of take over and form this kind of beautiful, luminescent skin that's completely unlike what it started out as. Within the film, a lot of the artworks kind of exist in this subliminal character state, in the environments of the characters behind them, in the apartments, bedrooms, offices. And I think they kind of, in a really subtle way, underscore Nina's transformation from woman to swan with these kind of very potent visual signifiers that have an energy of their own.